Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for May the 10th of 2021, well, it is titled Star Clusters M35 and NGC 2158. So what do we see here? Well, these are two star clusters in the constellation of Gemini, and they look very distinct. We can see one cluster down towards the lower left, very dominated by blue stars, and the other one in the upper right, dominated by yellower stars. Now, if we take a look at these two, it is M35 that is on the lower left. It's a relatively nearby cluster, and you might think that just by looking at the two clusters, certainly the one looks brighter and more spread out the nearby one, and the other one looks like it is further away just by looking at them, although it's hard to get an exact distance of that. What we cannot look at is the sizes of the stars. The size of a star on an image is related to how bright it is, nothing to do with its actual size. All stars are simply pinpoints of light through even the most powerful telescopes. So we can't say that these stars are closer because they look bigger. It's just that they are brighter stars. Now, M35 also is dominated by blue stars. It's a much younger star cluster, only about 150 million years old. So we see those stars there. It's also, as I said, relatively close at only less than 3,000 light years away from us. Now, when we look in the upper right, we see the star cluster known as NGC 2158, and it is four times further away, or well over 10,000 light years away, and it is much older, more than 1.5 billion years old, so 10 times the age. And we can tell that in part just by looking at these two clusters. The blue stars that we see in M35 do not live very long. Depending on the exact type, blue stars might live a few million years to tens of millions of years, maybe even 100 million years, but not 1.5 billion years. So all the stars that were blue that formed within NGC 2158 that were blue are long gone. They have evolved off the main sequence, become red giants, and likely completely gone to become, depending on the type of star, they could become a black hole, a neutron star, or a white dwarf. So they're all gone. And it is the stars that are left on the main sequence that dominate. And by now, they're going to be yellower or redder stars. So we start to see a distinct changing of the color of that cluster from the blue that we see on M35 to a distinct yellowish cluster of NGC 2158. And if we could wait longer or find an even older cluster, we would see that it was even more dominated by red stars. As the cluster gets older, the blue stars are all completely gone, and what's left are dominant red giant stars like our sun that have evolved off the main sequence and become red giants and red supergiants. So we're able to see all of those and those two types of clusters here in one image if we look with a small telescope toward the constellation of Gemini. So that was our picture of the day for May the 10th of 2021. It was titled Star Clusters M35 and NGC 2158. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Beyond Uluru. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.